We ask that you just allow each and every one of us to be a light and a beacon unto the world, Heavenly Father, so that we may be example to our family, friends, co-workers, so that they can see Christ in us, so that they will know, Father, that you are the light, the way, and the truth, Heavenly Father. Father, we come to you interceding for the sick and the shut-in. Father God, we just ask that you heal them and bring deliverance to their body, soul, and mind. Whether it's high blood pressure, diabetes, cancer, depression, or grief, we plead the blood of Jesus over them, Father. Father, we just thank you, Father. And we, Father, the prayer of faith shall save the sick and the Lord shall lift them up. Father, we know that Jesus healed the sick, Heavenly Father. He made the blind to see and the lame to walk. And he is the same yesterday, today, and forever, Father God. And we just stand on the word of God. There's life and there's power in his word. Jesus bore our sicknesses, carried our diseases, and by his stripes you are healed and made whole, Heavenly Father. And we just thank you, Father. And Father, we come praying for the ones that have lost loved ones, Heavenly Father. We ask that you put your arms of protection around them. Father, we just ask that you provide love, comfort, Heavenly Father, to them. Father God, we come to you just asking for revival in this place right now, Father. We ask that your holy and anointing presence fill this place right now. We ask that you do a new thing in us, Heavenly Father. Fill us with the Holy Spirit, Father, so that we see signs and wonders and the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, Father. Father, we ask for your protection. We ask for your power and protection against the attacks of the enemy, Father. We put on the full armor of God, the helmet of salvation, the blessed breastplate of righteousness, and the belt of truth around our loins, and the shield of faith. We ask you, Father, to send your angel, guardian, and ministering angels, Father, all around and about us, Father, to protect us, guide us, lead us, and direct us, Heavenly Father. Father, right now, we ask for your prayers for our pastor, the shepherd of this house, Dr. Tory. Father, we ask that you pour your holy and anointed oil on her head right now. Father, we ask that you continue to give her wisdom, discernment, and surround her with wise counsel so that she can continue to lead this flock, Heavenly Father. Father, we just ask that you blow fresh on her right now, Heavenly Father. Fill her from the top of her head to the soles of her feet so that she may be able to give us what thus says the Lord. And we praise you, Father, and we magnify your name right now in the precious name of Jesus. Our soul says amen. Amen.
Lord, we just thank you for being a way maker. Thank you, Jesus. For making ways, Lord God, where there is no way. Yes. Where doors are shut, God, you rip those doors open. And Lord, we thank you. We give you praise, Lord God. You are a way maker. You are a miracle worker. You are a promise keeper. You are a light in the darkness. That's just who you are.
Miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, yeah. That is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, That is who you are. You are here working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. You are here mending every heart. I worship you. I worship you. I worship you. I worship you.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Yes, he's a waymaker. You mend the broken heart. You're the answer to it all. Jesus, you wipe away the tears. You mend the broken heart. You're the answer to it all, to it all.
This morning, I will be delivering announcements. We only have a few, but first and foremost, I just wanted to let everyone know that today, Dr. Tori and the choir, they will be in ministry and traveling to Mount Moriah AME Church for their annual Usher's Day. Their service begins at 3:30 p.m., so if you wish to join her and the choir, see your email for the address of the church. As well, next week, we are so excited because we're going to be celebrating our homecoming, our church homecoming. Yes, that's a round of applause. So the Reverend Rodney Smothers, he's going to be our guest pastor for that day. And then our theme is moving toward wholeness in Christ, which is an amazing theme. We're excited, of course, and we wait in expectation for an anointed music service, and just youth, the dancers will be dancing. Yes, and a powerful word will be given. So I'm excited. I hope you are. I can't wait. So we only have 1 week to wait. secondly, we will be having brunch immediately after the service. So just know that in the fellowship hall, we will be having brunch. And Brother Albert Dobson, he states that homemade desserts are welcome. But thank you all for who contribute to that as well. In addition, this is just a gentle reminder. We've said it like many times weeks prior, but typically what we're doing as a sacrificial offering for every year the church has been up and running, we're giving a dollar if that's on your heart to do. So God has been faithful for our church for 134 years. That's amazing. So if it's something that's on your heart and you can do as a sacrificial offering, please do. That's amazing. If you need an envelope, you can see one of the ushers as well. If you're doing Cash App online giving, just make a notation that it's for homecoming or the anniversary of the church. And then the United Methodist Men, they're having the honor roll, as we know, and it's there's cash rewards for students. So students, next Sunday, homecoming Sunday, no later than the end of service is the deadline for submitting copies of your report cards and completing the ministry form as well that comes with it. So please make sure you submit them to either Mr. Jared Flemings, Mr. Gerard Flemings, and then Mr. Carol Hicks or Miss Carla Flemings in the church office. So next Sunday, it's also the deadline for you to submit to Mr. Sam Crowder, for the church council Christmas dinner. So that's going to be on Tuesday, December 6th. So just remember that checks are not made out to the church. So, and lastly, we're going to invite you to participate in our church-wide Advent Bible study. It's starting Wednesday, November 30th at 7 p.m., regularly scheduled Bible studies will be placed on hold until the conclusion of the church-wide Advent Bible study. The book that we are going to be coming from is called Mary Had a Baby, an African Advent Bible Study Based on African-American Spirituals. You can purchase a copy at Cokesbury or on Amazon. And as well, the church office actually has 4 books left, and it's $9. So please take time to review the weekly email that you're receiving, especially upcoming holiday services and events and days and times. And for those who don't have access to email, there are a few paper copies located on the table in the lobby. So yeah, thank you for your time and attention. This concludes the announcements. And now we will hear a word from the ATN Network as we continue to worship in our giving.
Greetings, Asbury Townette family and friends. Welcome to the ATN Network. Luke chapter 6, verse 38 reads, "Give, and it will be given to you, a good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, will be poured into your lap. For with the measure you use it, it will be measured to you. Therefore know, God takes whatever we give and multiplies it, so that we can be blessed to be a blessing." Brothers and sisters, currently we have 4 ways to give. You can call 410-647-3461 to arrange an in-person drop-off. You can mail your tithes and your offerings to 429 Asbury Drive, Severna Park, Maryland, 21146. Or you can visit our website, asburytownneck.org, and click the donate button. Or you can use the Cash App at $ATNUMC. Thank you for your continual support of the ministries of Asbury Townette United Methodist Church. We invite you to continue to join us for worship and the Word.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, everyone.
You know, sometimes we sound like we're still in bed, asleep. When we come to the house of the Lord, we should sound more cheerful. I'm going to invite you this morning to open your Bibles to Psalms 46. I'm going to be coming from that chapter. I'm going to be reading from verses 1 through 11. When you have it, would you please stand, please? And forgive my voice this morning. It's a little rough. All of us that have allergies know what it's like to have a rough voice because of it. So just continue to keep me uplifted in your prayers as I go forth with the scripture this morning. God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. Though the earth should change, though the mountains should shake, in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with a tumult, shalom. There is a river whose stream makes glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of the city. It is not to be moved. God will help it when the morning dawns. The nations are in an uproar, the kingdoms tottered. To utter his voice, the earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Shalom. Come, behold the work of the Lord. See what desolation he has brought to the earth. He makes war cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow. And he shatters the spear. He burns the shield with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. I'm going to go back to verse 46, if that's okay, Pastor. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Shalom. The word of God for the people of God.
Hallelujah. Give God some praise for the word. Hallelujah. We bless God for all that he's doing in this church. Next week, we're going to celebrate 134 years. Come on, give God glory. God has been so good to us. This is just a rehearsal. When we get to heaven, we're going to really sing. We're going to really sing. But we're getting some good practice. Hallelujah. Give God some glory. The Lord is my shepherd.
The Lord is my shepherd.
He goes before me.
He goes before me.
Defender behind me.
Defender behind me.
God didn't create a spirit of fear.
I won't fear.
I'm filled with anointing.
I'm filled with anointing.
Anybody got that blessing where your cup ran over?
My cup's overflowing.
Won't he protect you? No weapon can harm you.
No weapon can harm me.
of God, sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I am not alone.
I am not alone.
Oh, he's my comfort.
He's my comfort.
And he always holds me close.
Come on, shout Jesus some love. He always guides.
He always guides me.
Through mountains.
Through mountains and valleys.
Come on, somebody knows that his joy is refreshing.
His joy is refreshing.
His joy will restore.
Restores my soul.
That's that blessed assurance,
yeah.
That I'll see his glory.
I'll see his glory.
Face to face.
Face to face.
Oh, sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I am not alone.
Come on, team. Now tell them, say,
your spirit lives within me.
So I will walk.
So I will walk in your peace.
Tell them
your spirit lives within me.
It's my victory.
My victory.
Say,
your spirit lives within me.
So I will walk
in your peace.
Your spirit
lives within me.
Say, my victory. Your spirit
is within me.
So I will walk.
So I will walk in your peace.
Y'all just sing it real sweet. Give him the highest praise.
Sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I am not alone.
Come on, he'll never leave or forsake you. No matter what it looks like. Say, he's my comfort.
He's
God, glory. Come on, you are not alone. No matter how far you go, you can always come back home.
Yes, yes, yes.
But the secret is, he never left you anyway. Come on, he stayed right there. On those nights when you felt like you were all alone, balled up crying, pillars drenched with tears, he was right there. Right there in the midst. Come on, ask me how I know and I'll let you know. God has never left. Hallelujah. Somebody give God glory.
Of you are just glad that you are not alone, that we serve a God who continues to be with us each and every day, who wipes away our tears, who comes in the midst of our storms, who breathes new life onto us. How many of you are glad on today that we are not alone, that God sees us, he sits high and he looks low and he remembers us, he knows every hair that's on our head. Do you know that we serve a God who loves you? You may not feel loved by the world, but we serve a God who loves you. He loved you before the foundation of the earth. He loved you when you made mistakes. He loved you when you made missteps. He loved you when you didn't think there was a way out. He loved you. So this morning, we are just grateful for the love that God has in store for us. Hallelujah. Will you pray with me this morning? Gracious and eternal God, we are so grateful that you inhabit the praises of your people, God. God, we thank you that the Spirit of God was ushered in through our worship, oh God. God, we thank you that our worship is for real and is not in vain, oh God. God, we're just asking in the name of Jesus that you will come in and do only what you can do, which is heal us from the inside out, to make the wounded whole, to come in and breathe new life onto us so that we might experience your resurrection power. God, I pray on today that you will hide me behind your rugged cross and allow the Galilean preacher named Jesus to show up instead of me. Have your way, Holy Ghost, even now, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, we pray. Let the people of God say amen, amen, and amen. So I asked my brother Craig to come up and sing an old school song, old school hymn of the church, and we're going to tie this thing in, and maybe you might know this song.
Amen, amen. If you don't know it, we're going to teach it to you real quick. So come on, stand to your feet. We're going to sing, give Pastor Oop off the backboard, so to speak. Come on, put your hands together. Come on, help me sing.
Well, victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today. I told Satan to get thee behind. Victory. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today. I told Satan to get thee behind. Victory. Joy. Anybody having happiness today? I told Satan to get thee behind happiness. I got one more verse. Come on, y'all. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today. Bless the Lord.
Hallelujah. 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 I got us to sing Victory is Mine because Psalm 46 is a song of victory. Let me say that again. Psalm 46 is a psalm of victory. It's a psalm of celebration. It's a psalm to recognize that Jerusalem is now safe. It's a secure place. It's the city of the living God. It's a place where we can begin to rest in the presence of God. This morning, I'm going to do some teaching and some preaching because Psalm 46 is so rich with so much history and things for us to grab our teeth into. So this is a meat type of sermon. Amen. Amen. So again, they are singing this song of victory. Psalm 46 is actually it's a worship song. If you look at the fine print at the top of the psalm, it says, "For the director of music of the sons of Korah." Now, the director of music, anybody that's going to direct music in the house of the Lord is going to be a Levite. So a Levite was, remember, there are 12 tribes in Israel, and the Levitical tribe is the priestly tribe. So this were the people that were in charge of public worship. Y'all with me this morning? Like I said, we're going to do some teaching and some preaching. And so the sons of Korah is actually a Levitical choir. These are people that are part of this priestly tradition. They are a choir that are coming up to sing these praises. And it says, according to Alamoth, and that sounds a little weird. And I said, okay, God, well, what does that mean? And according to Alamoth, it refers to these young women who were playing the timbrels, who accompanied the singers. So they had some backup. They weren't just singing on their own. They just weren't chanting on their own. They had some instrumentation along with them. What I love about Victory is Mine, going back to the song we just sung, it kind of goes into what in the Black church tradition we call hymn lining, where you hear a piece of the song, right? And then we know what the rest of the lyrics mean, right? And that's a part of the call and response tradition that we have in church. And when we go to Psalm 46, Psalm 46 is actually an example of call and response. Come on, preacher, well, break it down for you. Sure will, why not? So verses 1-3 were sung by the citizens of Jerusalem. So the people sang the beginning part of this psalm. And then when we get to verses 4-6, then you have the leader, the Levitical priest, who is leading the other parts of the psalm. And then 7-11 kind of get a little mixed up. 7-11, 8-10, they kind of go back and forth between the people and the leader. Y'all with me? So this is a communal song. This isn't sung on its own. This isn't something that was just read or anything like that. No, they actually sang this. This was a worship song. They were inviting people into a worship experience. They were inviting people into knowing this God of their salvation. Because remember, we're still at the point where this is just simply the God of Israel. We haven't gotten to Jesus yet. And so they are exalting this God who is their refuge and strength, the very present help in the time of trouble, because they understand, therefore we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains should shake and the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and form, though the mountains tremble with its tumult. Well, Pastor, that sounds real poetic. But what does that mean? Anybody with me this morning? We're going to get deep this morning. Verses 1 through 3 is really about learning how to trust and depend on God. Can we go there this morning? Verses 1 through 3 is a reminder that God is our refuge and our strength, a very help in the time of trouble. That means that God is with us when bad things happen. God is with us though the earth may shake and change, and the mountains may shake and the heart of the sea. And though it might seem like there is water that's roaring and foaming and the mountains might tremble, that means that things might be a little bit unsteady and maybe a little bit shaky, but we can trust and depend on God in the midst of all of that, because he does not shake. He does not move. He's in the midst of all things. And if you need some witnesses, all we got to do is look at Abraham and Sarah as they received the word from the Lord in Genesis 12 to go into the land in which I tell you to go. And just as they're going through the land, each and every stop along the way, even when they face some enemies, God continues to cover them. And if you don't know about Abraham and Sarah, maybe they're not your cup of tea. Maybe you need to go on and go with the Israelites who survived the 10 plagues in Egypt that try to wipe everybody out, but they are still standing. And maybe that's just not good enough for you. Maybe you got to remember that while they were wandering in the wilderness, there was something that came from heaven. It was called manna, literally mean what is this? And God began to provide for them in the wilderness by making sure their bellies were full on their way to the promised land. Now, if you need one more witness, because I believe that every now and then we need somebody just to witness to the glory of God about what does it mean to trust and depend on God. There was a woman named Rahab who lived in Canaan, and she didn't have the best reputation, but she had some wisdom and discernment about her. So that when the spies came to look at the land in which God had promised the Israelites, she said, "You know what? I'll hide you in my house. But if I hide you in my house, when you come back, I need you to remember me and my family. So I'm going to trust and depend on God's word, that God is going to cover us in the midst of this turmoil that's about to befall my nation." Then there was this other woman. Maybe you know of her. Her name was Hannah, and we find her in the temple, and she is crying out to God, and the prophet of God actually thinks she's a little bit crazy, but she's weeping because she is trying and hoping and pleading for God for a son. And in this trusting and believing that God will show up, the prophet of God showed up, and now she was able to conceive and have a son named Samuel, and Samuel would be the one who anoints the king of Israel. So I don't know about you, but when I read my text this morning, it's a reminder that God is somebody I can trust in and depend on, because he is my ever-present help in the time of trouble. Then there's this little word in the text, y'all, just in case. Sometimes it just creeps in and we see it written, and commentators don't really know exactly what it means, but they gave a couple understandings of the word, a couple of interpretations. Maybe you've heard this word, Selah. Have you heard the word Selah before and you're like, okay. So there's just this uncertain meaning around Selah. But some say it means to lift up or exalt, while others believe that it's a musical notation that means silence or pause. So when I come across Selah in the psalm, it reminds me to pause and reflect on who God is and what God has done. So when I get to this Selah, this little teeny word in the text, after I have reminded myself who God is, that he is my ever-present help in a time of trouble, it causes me to pause and again reflect on all the testimonies I gave you in the word of God. Because sometimes, y'all, we forget that we can trust in God, that we can depend on God, that God's word is true. And so when we get to Selah, it's a reminder that we need to pause and remember. Hallelujah. when we get to Selah, it means to pause and remember. Now, this is the verse. Verse 4 is kind of what caught me up. So number one, in this, as we talk about who God is, we learn that God is somebody that we can trust and depend on. And the second thing that we can know is that God is the source of our blessings. Well, Pastor, well, why don't you break that down for us? Go on with me to verse 4. It says, there is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. Now, I want to give you some historical background. Jerusalem doesn't have a river. This is about the holy city. Jerusalem doesn't have a river, but yet it says there is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. The river is a metaphor for the continual outpouring of blessings and refreshing that God gives us. So if we're in a worship, y'all, because remember, this is a worship song. If we're in worship, worship should be refreshing. It should pour into us so that we can pour out to others. And so when we come into worship, when we worship God together, when we engage in this call and response moment, as God is pouring into us, we are pouring into each other so that when we leave this place, when we leave the worship experience, we're not leaving empty, we're leaving full, because we have encountered one who has guaranteed that his blessings are everlasting, y'all. They continue to pour over us. God continues to refresh us. Maybe I need to say it this way, just in case you're missing this right now, that God is a wellspring. God is the living water in the midst of the desert. God is the one that we can drink from when our well is dry, when we don't have nothing else to give. God provides a river in the holy city. That means God provides a river in the midst of your mess, so that when you feel like you're not enough, when you feel like you don't have enough power or enough strength or enough whatever, enough fortitude to keep pressing on, you can go to the river of God, no matter where you are, and drink from that river and know that God is filling you up to overflow, so that you don't have to operate out of lack, but you can operate out of abundance, because we serve an abundant God who is ready and willing to bless you. Let me break it. Let's go on down. So we understand that God is somebody that we can trust and depend on, that God is the source of our blessings, and blessings means favor and protection. God is the source of all those things, because we know that God is the living water, the river in the midst of our dying and desert situations. But God is also what? Victorious. God is victorious. Well, Pastor, how do you know that? I can go into verse 5. Come on with me to verse 5. Y'all with me, y'all? Come on with me to verse 5. It says, God is in the midst of the city. He shall not be moved. God will help when the morning dawns. All right, Pastor, come on, work that out for us. Work that out for us. The morning is the time of day when attack would typically come. Let me say that again. The morning is the time of day when attacks against cities were typically launched. Let me make it plain for us in our modern day way of thinking. As we come up on the 81st anniversary of Pearl Harbor, when was Pearl Harbor attacked? Pearl Harbor was attacked before 8 o'clock in the morning. So let me make it real plain for us, y'all. So God is victorious, because when the attacks come in the morning at the expected time, maybe it's unexpected time, maybe you weren't ready, maybe you were up brushing your teeth and you get that call in the morning, maybe you were sleeping through the night and you get the call in the middle of the night that something tragic has happened, maybe you just had these moments where you're trying to figure out, God, these missiles are getting fired at me on every side, but yet the word tells us that God is in the midst of the city, meaning that God is in the midst of our stuff, God is in the middle of all the things that are circling around us. And so when the enemy tries to attack us in the morning, in the noonday, in the midnight hour, the scripture tells me that God is in the midst of it all. And so if I need to go on to my friend Paul, he says, and for we know that all things work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to his purpose. And so if we have that blessed assurance from our brother Paul, then we can understand that God is in the midst of it all. The scripture tells us that nations are going to uproar, that kingdoms may totter, and that he utters his voice and the earth melts. It means in all of this, no matter how loud the enemy roars, no matter how loud the enemy tries to get in your face and press up against you, God is victorious in the midst of all of this. And so if we are connected to God, can I get a witness on here today? If we are connected to God because he is, we are. Let me, Julius got that. Maybe I need to go on over here real quick. Because we are connected to God, Mimi, because we understand that God is victorious, because we know who God is, because he is, we are. So if we are, that means we are victorious too. Maybe I'm still preaching to myself this morning. But when I read this text, there's something that begins to happen, because when we get into the midst of this, as we begin to understand that God is victorious and we are victorious too, God says, come and look at what I am doing. Come, the scripture says, come and behold the works of the Lord and see what desolation he has brought on the earth. This is an invitation to acknowledge what God has done, the victories over enemies that God has made happen. If we need to go in the text, we can look at all of the victories that David had had. We can look at how Jehoshaphat was able to overcome his enemies by looking up and saying, God, I don't know what to do, but my eyes are on you. So all of a sudden, we can begin to look at what God has done in the midst of the scripture. But in the midst of all of this, there is this directive, Minister Trudy, that reminds us, because in the midst of all of this, there's this call and response. Remember that there's this conversation between the people and the leader of worship, and then all of a sudden, we hear a word from the Lord. Don't miss it. There's this call and response where they're talking about God, and then God decides to talk to them. Let me say that again. There's a moment in the scripture where the scripture shifts from the leader and the people talking about God to God talking to them. And he says, be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth. So again, we move from the priests and the people telling us who God is, and so God inviting us to pause and acknowledge who God is. Let me tease that out again. We move from the people telling us who God is to God inviting us to know who God is. Inviting us to Selah, to pause and know who God is. Our singers today said, the Lord is with us. They kept singing that. That was a reminder that God has not forsaken us, that God is with us. And so does the psalmist. The psalmist says in the very last verse, the Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. At the end of this call and response, they again remind us who they said God was from the very beginning. That God is our refuge. If you look in different parts of scriptures, they may say it a little differently. They may say God is our fortress. If you know that old hymn of the church, it says, mighty fortress is our God. Amen. That means that this God is one who fortifies us, who loves us, who just comes in the midst of all things. So we talk about God as somebody that we can trust and depend on. God is victorious, and God is the source of our blessing. Now, it wouldn't be me if I didn't just go through some names of God, just in case you need somebody, need some reminders of who God is on today. Because maybe you just didn't connect with Psalm 46. Maybe it just wasn't for you this morning. But maybe one of these names might just begin to resonate in your spirit. And if this is you, I pray that you begin to just raise your hand in the sanctuary, because I want you to know this is how God is showing up for you right now, or how God has showed up for you in the past, so that when you get in these times of trouble, that you remember who God is for you. The Old Testament calls him El Shaddai, which is the Lord God Almighty. The Old Testament also calls him Elohim, which is the Creator God, which is Adonai, the Lord God, Jehovah Nisi, the Lord that's our banner, Jehovah Ra'ah, the Lord that's my shepherd, Jehovah Rapha, the Lord that heals. Maybe that's you this morning. Jehovah Shammah, the Lord that is there. How many of you know that we serve a God who is there? Maybe God is Jehovah Sikanu, which is the Lord that's our righteousness. And maybe God is El Olam, which is the Lord that's our everlasting God. That's the one who is now the same and was there for us yesterday, today, and forevermore. Maybe he's Jireh for you. Maybe he's your provider. Hallelujah. Maybe he's Jehovah Shalom. Maybe he's your peace. Maybe he is El Roi, the God who sees you in the midst of your tribulation. And maybe if we go down to the New Testament, maybe he's Jesus, the God who is your Savior and your Redeemer. Maybe God is your Comforter. Maybe he's the author and perfecter of your faith. Maybe he's the consolation of your life. Maybe he's your cornerstone. Maybe he's your deliverer. Maybe he's Emmanuel, God that is with you. Maybe he's your faithful and true witness. Maybe he's the friend of you who once was a sinner and hoping to be a saint. Maybe he's your great shepherd. Maybe he's your high priest. Maybe he's the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world and has mercy on you. Maybe he's the light of the world. Maybe he's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Maybe he's the Lord God Almighty, the one who's strong in battle. Maybe he's your refuge in the time of storm. Maybe he's the Lord God Almighty, the one who was and is and will come back again. Because God is. Because God is. God is. And because God is, we are. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, may we give God thanks and praise. May we enter into his courts with thanksgiving. May we give him thanks and praise for all that he's done for us. Because when we come to Psalm 46, it's an opportunity to worship God Almighty. It's an opportunity for us to engage with the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Because God is our refuge. Our ever-present help in the time of trouble. Would you pray with me this morning? Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Lord God, we thank you so much for all that you are doing. God, we thank you that, as my brother planned, that you are our all in all, God. And so, God, we know that you're the source of our strength and the strength of our life, God. And God, there may be somebody in the room who just needed to be reminded who you are in their lives. And so, Lord Jesus, I pray that on today that somebody had an encounter with you, that somebody's life was transformed by you, that somebody knows you more intimately and more deeply this morning, that somebody was able just to tap into the power and the presence of an almighty God who sees and knows and heals and delivers, and who has not forgotten you on today. So Lord God, I pray for those that are in this room, that they might know you and love you as you know and love them. God, I pray for forgiveness. I pray for peace. I pray for joy. I pray that hope would be restored. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, we pray, amen. Is there one in the sanctuary who does not know him in the pardoning of your sins and you would like to know him on today? Is there one who would like to know God more intimately? Is there one? Is there one who would like to rededicate their life to Jesus? Maybe you were going left and it's time for you to go right. Maybe you just need to be reminded that there is a place for you. Would you raise your hand in the sanctuary or let us know in the chat box below online, and we would love to pray with you. Is there one who would like to join this branch of Zion? If so, would you come forward at this time? Hallelujah. Come forward, Brother Moon. Amen. 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 Amen, amen, amen. I have some questions for you this morning. We got some men that's going to come and stand with you because they love you. Brother Moon has been singing with our Johnson Mail chorus for years and years. And he also says it's his birthday, so we're so glad that you would join us on your birthday. And Mike, watch out. You got some people coming from behind. Amen, 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 amen. So as I ask these questions, I ask that you respond by saying I do. All right. On behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin? Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? Do you confess that Jesus Christ is your Savior? Do you put your whole trust in his grace and promise to serve him as your Lord in union with the church which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races? Do you promise to give of your gifts, your service, your talents, and your witness? All for the glory of God, we say welcome home, Brother Moon. Welcome home. Glory. God be the glory. Amen. Amen. Brother Moon, won't you sit over there for me, and we're going to, if you would like to shake hands on the way out, you can. If you want to bump elbows, you can. Amen. 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 We invite everyone at this time to stand on your feet. Everybody stand on your feet. Thank you so much. Will you raise your hand in the sanctuary as we give the benediction? We want to remind you that the offering baskets are in the front of the church. If you're able, please join me at 3:30 for the usher's anniversary. I would love, love, love to have you. Gracious and eternal God, we are so grateful and thankful for all that you have done for us. God, we thank you that you are. God, we thank you that because you are, we are, oh God. And so, Lord, we know that you are somebody we can trust and depend on. God, we know that you are someone who is the source of our blessings. God, we know that you are victorious. And because you are victorious, so are we. And so, God, help us take that word with us for the rest of the day. Lord, we love you. Lord, we thank you. God, we thank you for not leaving us nor forsaking us, but walking in the midst with us, because we know that although the earth may tremble, although things around us may be unshaky and unsteady, we serve a God who changes not. And for that, we give you thanks and praise. Lord, we love you. Lord, we adore you. Lord, we just worship you today and forevermore. Amen and amen. We love you, family. There's nothing you can do about it. Go and make today a great one.
But we get up, we fall down, but we get up, oh yes. For a saint is just a sinner who